Okay, we're good. We don't have the crazy smoke happening to us.
Whoever was here made off in a hurry.
That's an astute observation. But maybe whoever was here was, you know, alive during bombs flying down and said, "Hey, you know what? Maybe I don't want to be in this house." But maybe there's more to it. They have a chained up door. Somebody had time to chain up the door and then ditch their house. That's kind of backwards in the chain of events, don't you think? Although here's a safe. Novice lock safe. Wait. No! What did I just pick up? I didn't know that was a letter. Shit. I have to look back at my stream. Oh, fuck. I just picked it up too fast. Well, this looks like a pleasant area to live in. Let me see what this note's all about. Apparently it's a note. Here we go, sleepwalking note. Then you promise to return. When you don't, I really burn. Well, I guess I'll never learn. That's such a random name. And it was in the box, so I didn't know it was gonna be there. And if you're kind, and don't keep us apart, make up. Alright. Kathy, move your bed downstairs. Your sleepwalking is gonna be the death of you. Why, do they walk out the window and fall off? Because that would be interesting. I love you so much, honey. I just got to know. I'm just a fool for you. I was hoping there'd be some kind of, like, secret. Like, oh, honey, we ran down to the store down the street. Turns out they have a nuclear bomb. A nuclear bomb. Maybe they shouldn't have a nuclear bomb. It turns out they have a bomb shelter underneath their house. Hope we can find you there, and then I go over there. I'm so sorry for shooting you, Nick. I got on edge. Where the hell am I? This place just doesn't have a name, but it has, you know, a lot going on for it. Well, you can't go into the waffle store. That place is pretty destroyed. But how destroyed? Not a lot. Jesus Christ. I mean, I guess this place could just be called Old Gullet, because this is called the Old Gullet Sinkhole. So yeah, fine, we'll call it Old Gullet. These people died absolutely super quick. They're just chilling out, maybe they're playing cards, or maybe they drank themselves to death with vodka. I just don't know. What are you trying to tell me here, Bethesda? People drank themselves to death just as the apocalypse came down? I can believe it. Ooh, nice. They have a safe built into the thinnest walls ever.
Got it.
I like how they modeled this little interior area, but we can't get into it. Most of the time they just say, no, it's those windows, you can't, they're all blocked off, you can't go in there. Get out of here, please. Not that particular
Fallout.
Area.
Fallout.
Oh hey, it's Vault 75. Ah. Alright, well, I want to check this area first. What's going on at the bigger pool, or the bigger pond?
The
there are some recent rumblings from good news. And I believe that is something of a part of the self-proclaimed and legitimate businesswoman, Bobby No-Nos, and something of a reputation around the Commonwealth.
Dark Hollow Pond.
That reputation may have contributed.
That's kind of ominous sounding. Welcome to the Dark Hollow Pond. Where everything is dark and or hollow. Why is it hollow?
Word is, there's no trace of your good neighbor.
I don't know, honestly.
This time, whether she actually pulled off the job, she was rumored to have been a bottle of Or, if something suggests, she crossed the wrong people and won't be seen anywhere again, ever. If you get my people. For anyone coming back to Diamond City from a trip out of the Commonwealth, for you.
I like how we've been by this little pond before, but I guess we just didn't get close enough to it to get the name. That's a little ridiculous, but alright. I'm gonna check out this mass views and containment shed, because it's the weirdest thing on my map at the moment. It's an area that says it's clear, but I've never been in it, so what the hell's going on with it? I mean, obviously, maybe it's just a clear place in general. Ah, crap. We'll see. Hey there! Nope. Please don't do this to me. Alright, you're spitting acid already. Wow, that one just died immediately. I'm pretty content about that one. Oh, jeez. Why are bugs so aggressive? Especially after their birth. Get out of here. I mean, I guess there also could just be a lobster crustacean, whatever you want to call it.
Uh-oh.
Special. You're getting an extra dose of radiation.
I'm super mutant. I am strong. Yes, we're all super mutants. No, but I'm special super mutant. No, you're not.
What is going to be inside the mass containment shed? It looks really interesting already, at least from the outside. It's a warehouse full of radiation and ghouls. Oh, I might as well take my rad radiation resistance. Where is it under? Here we go. Rad X! I think you can stack Rad X? Let me see. Okay, so we have 1,150. If I take another one, it does stack. Okay. No radiation damage from me. Or very, very tiny amounts. Yes. And then there wasn't even all that much in here anyways, jeez. Oh, I see a fusion thing. How do I open you? Ah, by copious amounts of hacking. All right, what do we got for these personal logs?
After 30 days of being accident-free, Lester tripped behind the forklift while he was backing up. Now we're back to zero. Also, corporate made us put up all the Remember Your Hard Hat posters, like that would have saved his life. The company retreat is coming up in a couple of weeks. Mr. Field said it's mandatory for all employees, especially supervisors. I hate going to those things.
It's bad enough having to deal with these people during the week. Now I have to pretend I like them for a whole weekend? Sometimes I envy Lester. A hazardous material inspector stopped in today to unannounced to check out our operation. I started to feel like he was getting suspicious of what was actually going on around here. I told Mr. Feld, and he said if the inspector started catching on, we needed to get rid of him. And it didn't mean to ask him to go away. Well, he caught on, so we had to get rid of him. If anyone finds out what we did, they'll put away, or put, they'll put me away for life. Did you guys just bury him away in here, or did you put him inside of one of the barrels of radiation? Oh my gosh. What does this button do? Boop! Oh. It just closes the door. I guess I could do that for a little bit of added safety for myself. Nice. It's gotta be remain somewhere. Aha! Did they make that guy into a ghoul? I'd say they probably killed him and then maybe buried him back here. Oh, I understand now. So what they've been doing is taking these barrels and then just dumping the shit into the sewers? Oh, that's fucked up. Just like all the other bad places. Nick, you need to chill out. Nick? Buddy? You're gonna be okay! Just hold on, Nick! You're gonna be alright! I think I fixed him. Well, I haven't found a body, just lots of ghouls and the chance that maybe they threw him into the sewer as well, but maybe he was still alive. And so he was locked there, being irradiated. But that happened pretty early on, so that would have mean that would have meant that guy would be a first ghoul kind of scenario, which I doubt. So I think they just murdered him. It happens. People die quite a lot in Fallout. Sometimes for really dumb reasons. Oh, there was a bug under there too. So that's it? The mass containment fusion building was just there to make us go, damn! They fucked with nature more! They keep on doing it! Alright, well, I gotta help people out. Oh, look at all these areas that I haven't been to yet. This is why the Let's Play isn't done yet. So much shit for me to go to. I say I'll care forever, and I mean forever. If I have to hold up the sky, crazy he calls me. Sure, I'm crazy.
What the fuck was that?
Crazy. That was your death. Incoming! I like how instead said caution rather than danger. That implies he didn't actually fully see me, but he was running right in front of me. So, about that. Ooh. 50% more limb damage for a crippling sniper. Laser sniper, rather.
Here's the latest word on what's happening in the Commonwealth, folks. Not content with sitting quietly at the airport, the Brotherhood...
Brotherhood is still up to shenanigans once again! When will they ever stop? Will all our ghoul friends have to die? Well, we here at Diamond City don't like ghouls, because we are racist. Oh, that's dirt. Have I really never been in here before?
Not that it's an option.
It feels like I haven't been, because I don't recognize this whole thing, and I definitely would have probably had some kind of vague memory of, oh yeah, that one place I ran into with the fucking bright-ass light. And dynamic shadows! Unless you're in first person. But in third person, whoa! If you get closer, you'll end up disappearing. Oh. But you do slightly become bigger. It just has a limit. Yeah, discovery music. I don't know what I discovered, but we're happy.
That's it.
Someone made a real mess of you, didn't they?
Detective Valentine. Nick. Listen, I'm sorry. You've got every right to be upset. You need to believe me when I tell you I had no idea. Operation Winter's End was my baby. I believed in it. I still believe in it. They kept us all in the dark, me included. I got briefed this afternoon. They laid it all up. The whole thing. Winter's deal with the DA, his agreement to bring down the other families, his idea to record the holotapes and incriminate all known associates, and them needing a legitimate op. And a real task force to make it all look like Winter was the focus. It was the plan all along, Nick. There's nothing we can do. Winter was a stoolie for the feds. He reported directly to the BADTFL, all on the books. For his cooperation, Winter will be granted total immunity. It's over. Effective immediately, Operation Winter's End is to cease all investigations and operations. The task force is hereby disbanded. We played our part, pal. Not the part we thought, but hey, it happens. Now we're just another box in the file room. Nick, listen to me. Everything that's happened, Winter, Jenny, it's more than any one man should have to handle. You need help. Boston PD has been working with the eggheads at CIT. Some new program they have to deal with trauma. Scanning brain waves or some such.
Ooh.
I'll get you the info. You're going. That's an order.
Hey.
Do something for you?
Take that weapon.
So now we know how Nick's brain scan got to the Institute. Well, not maybe got to, but why it's there. It's a very similar scenario to a different game that we played. But I won't say anything because spoilers. I was really sad. I was hoping that, like, Nick Valentine would say something. I'd be like, holy shit, they do sound alike. But I guess, to be fair, what if he had found this area before he found Nick Valentine? Well, I think it would be even cooler, actually, because then you'd be like, whoa, shit, you're alive? And then you realize, oh, wait, he has robot things. That brain scan thingy I listened to. Ah. And it just have a little bit of depth to it, you know? Ooh, hello.
Excellent.
Guns and bullets. Ballistic weapons permanently deal 5% extra critical damage.
Sure made a mess of this place, didn't they?
I need to get like a 50 to 100 crit boost. Or 3,000 crit boost. And that'd be good. Oh, there's evidence lock key.
Where'd that little fucker go?
Nick, if you see anybody, shoot him on sight. I'm a little busy looking for those tapes. Ooh. The fuck happened here? Somebody's hands are left over. But the cuffs are here. Oh. Somebody lost their arms. I don't know if your police department was all that safe.
Get your panties in a twist.
Going. What? No!
Rescue Sailor from... I shot the fucking settler! Oh no! Oh no! I fucking sniped the settler! Nick, I'm a bad person. I'm a bad person. That poor bird. Either I sniped the settler, or I pissed them off and they shot the settler themselves. I don't know.
Someone there?
I'm just gonna walk in and shoot.
Anyone, you walk away.
This time we're just clearing this place up a little bit faster. That way I don't have to worry about, oh, I need to shoot people. No, no, we're good. Everyone's dead now. Jesus Christ. So it definitely was the person that I shot. God damn it. How was I supposed to know the person I could see from all the way across the room was a good person? Maybe they should have built up their health stats. You know, so they could survive a bullet to the head. Jeez. Oh, oh, I found it. It's all the way to the right. I hate when these saves have a weapon in them, because I just want to like open it up, press R, and move on with my life, but the game goes, no, no, you stop being so loot happy. You sit there and calculate. All right, what's on the computer that I was supposed to find beforehand? Winter holotape logs. In storage, in the evidence room, on loan to Officer White. Well, we know where every single thing is, so... we good. Uh-oh. So here's a suicide. Mr. Black. One bullet recovered from Black during autopsy. But five bullets recovered from the walls of the apartment? What? That doesn't add up. So one bullet hit him and they said, hey, it was a suicide. And they were like, wait, shit, there's five other bullets. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's not a suicide. Holy shit. 158 bottles, buff out, 68 cartons of gray tortoise cigarettes, and one tactical nuclear launcher with ammo. Awaiting collection by Sergeant Groves. Okay. I'm pretty sure there's stuff in here that I have to re-grab. Damn it.
Sweet. There we go.
While the guy could have shot, like, maybe miss shooting himself five times? I doubt it. I mean, we're getting this evidence from a police terminal, and so there's a good chance that it just kind of... it implies shenanigans happened. I just did does twice, my god, okay. Personal logs. Sergeant Dave Mallory. Log, September 28th, 77. All right, data's corrupted, shit. October 3rd, it's October 22nd, here we go.
I'm in too old for this job. If I have to deal with one more loose cannon officer playing by his own rules, I'm gonna lose my goddamn mind. If it's not Wilson destroying private property again, it's that maniac Gibbs putting his life on the line. I swear, this whole squad is the reason I've got this ulcer. If the heartburn doesn't get me, it's the constant trips to the bathroom. Getting old is a bum deal. Thank God, only 3 more days until retirement. Then I can maybe take the RV out to the woods, rent a cabin, and finally finish my novel.
Wait, is this the guy who never even started on his novel because he was mad at the fucking construction site workers? Because that would be kind of funny. Okay, Valentino, we have to go. Any winner's tape, holotape zero. Alright, we're gonna listen to that. But I kinda wanna listen to them all in a row. So that way, they're a little bit more cohesive.
There we go.
Let's see. Luke Paul Jackson, bail posted. He had a leather wallet, plastic comb, and $50. Possession of unlicensed laser. Well then. Okay, what about this person? File corrupted. Possession of unlicensed laser. Another unlicensed laser wielder? Possession with intent to distribute. And what about the last guy? File corrupted. Alright. I'm really amused that someone can get arrested for having a laser. I'm assuming it's a laser gun, but it could just be a regular, like, point of things laser, but I doubt it. I don't think people get arrested for that kind of thing. Okay, ordinary. Holy shit, it's barbaric.
Got
it. I'm just clicking all these other places. I'm like, I gotta know. I gotta get everyone. I'm sad that none of these guys around her had a key. But hey, it's a novice lock, so I would have been able to unlock it even without any lockpick upgrades.
Help me now, right?
Nah. I don't think I can get you out of here.
Don't worry. I'm here to rescue you.
Oh my god. Thank you. Let's go.
Oh, she booked it. Oh no, she didn't.
Got a dangerous look about you. Hope you ain't here for me.
I just rescued you. And you definitely wanted me to be here for you when I rescued you. Jesus. She went a little bit too quickly into back into settler mode. These people better be happy that I'm running around saving their lives. Saving the settlements that I don't even care that much about, but I still feel a little bit of an obligation to check out. Jerks. Have I been here? Oh yeah, no, this is where we encountered that synth versus man scenario that we couldn't disarm.